Hello, everyone. Recently, someone gave me this great suggestion. What happens when you put mixed seeds into the greenhouse in winter? The reason this is such a curiosity is normally you plant the mixed seeds outside during spring, summer, or fall, obviously, the normal seasons when you can plant, and they'll give you random crops from the season they're planted in. For example, I believe spring will give you either potatoes, parsnips, or cauliflower. And like the description says, there's a little bit of everything here. Plant them and see what grows. What I'm really actually hoping for is a new spouse to grow, because I'm running out of entertainment with these people. Mixed seeds definitely are something I should be using a lot more in my legitimate playthroughs, because they can actually make you quite a bit of gold really easily, because you tend to just find them everywhere along the way as you play. The most common way that everyone finds them is cutting weeds. You cut so many weeds on your farm, you could probably spend your first day doing that and gather as many mixed seeds as you possibly can. In fact, that might be a video for me coming up. You can also get them from digging up the worm artifact spots on the ground, or from fishing from treasure chests, which is a pretty disappointing result, but might as well get some value out of it. And they're sold by Krobus on Thursdays for 30 gold each for some reason. So if you ever want to be weird and stock up, go see Krobus. And apparently the golems on the wilderness farm drop them once slain. So if you want to play in a wilderness farm and kill some monsters, great, there's kind of a use for that. Anyways, this is what happened when we planted these in fall, just out of curiosity. You see, it's a nice balance of things. We have pumpkins, eggplants, and corn, if I'm not mistaken. And artichokes, so we actually get a variety of four for fall. But obviously we're not in winter, and this isn't what we're here to determine. So what we're gonna do is move this into winter, fill up that greenhouse, see what happens. I just realized for perhaps the first time ever that when you pick the right pumpkins, they actually turn up blue in the lower left. One of the interesting things about the fall mix seeds is two of these are continually growing, both the corn and the artichoke. So plant them at the beginning of the season, let them grow. I like the renewable crops because they let them grow right till the end of the month and then they die, and they're really, really easy to replant the next day because all you gotta do is scythe them out of the way and plant where their corpses lie. Obviously not in winter though, unless you're using winter seeds, which can be fun in itself. And by the way, winter seeds was what I thought might happen when I planted the mixed seeds in the greenhouse, but we'll find out shortly. If you want to see the value of what those few mixed seeds were worth, 10,000 gold, easily from that. I think there was 60, 65 seeds there. But that's not what we're here for, not at all. We're here to hold worms and find more mixed seeds. Nope, just a stone. Also exciting though, about as exciting as mixed seeds to be honest. This is what we're gonna fill with mixed seeds. But we're not gonna do it just yet. We've gotta clear some stuff out, and then we've gotta skip to the end of the month. That felt good. I'm surprised it didn't hoe up these spots. These are gonna disappear long before winter starts anyway. I was just annoyed the bombs didn't take care of that. That's better. All right, simply skip it into winter. We're gonna fill that up with mixed seeds, see what shows up for us. Here we go with everyone's least favorite season in Stardew Valley, winter. But done right, it can actually be a really useful season. You just can't do a lot of the big crops that everyone loves to do, me especially. One winter root. Okay, so first thing I gotta do, obviously, hoe this up. And I'm gonna use bombs to do that because I'm lazy and bombs are a lot more fun. Step number two, remove the bombs from my hotbar because I have a bad habit of placing bombs after things are done and blowing everything up. There's been more than one or two videos ruined by doing that. Step number two, work very hard to run around the map gathering 999 mixed seeds. Definitely got these legitimately, don't even worry about it. So we should get some clue as to what these are based on their appearance, because when you lay the seeds down, all the seeds do actually look unique. They're all individual from each other, and I'm actually seeing quite a wide variety of things here. So I'm thinking these might actually give you crops from across all the seasons, or at least a few of them. But it's actually kind of hard to tell because we got the orange ones here, the really light colored ones here, and we'll call these popcorn. These ones are like an off-brand popcorn, and these are different again. So that's five seeds right there. Then there's some blue ones, so six. So I think we're getting a multitude of seeds. We might even get the winter seeds thrown in here too. The winter forageables, I'm not really sure. Today is the first. So the only question is, what do we do now? Do we wait for these to grow, water them every day, or do we make them grow now? That way we have a whole month to mess with them. Since I'm currently drinking some very strong coffee and getting very well caffeinated quickly, we're gonna make them grow now because I don't wanna wait. And we're getting crops from across the seasons. Okay, so we're getting spring, summer, and fall's mixed seeds all in one greenhouse right now. Well, if you ever want a very large and strange variety of crops in your greenhouse at once, plant mixed seeds in winter. You'll get a whole variety of things and not much use out of it really. It is kind of an interesting concept though. Should we see what all this is worth? Why does that require? Oh, because it's hay, it requires a scythe. Actually, I should probably turn that on anyway to make this harvest a little bit faster. I used to think this was such an odd option, harvest with scythe. And then I harvested a whole bunch of things I didn't want to harvest, and then I understood. So if we go like this though, the corn and artichokes are still going to stay along with whatever crops we get that are continually growing. That's interesting. I wonder if they'll die at the end of the month. I suppose not. They'll keep growing forever. So maybe don't do this or you can have corn growing endlessly. Well, the question now, what is this worth? Let's find out. My theory, not that much. But it's going to be some kind of value, and it would be something to do in winter. But that's always the goal for winter. Have a greenhouse, and you can actually still plant stuff. One greenhouse full of free seeds. Keep in mind this would be basically pure profit because you're probably not buying mixed seeds. And if you are, stop. Though they actually might be pretty cost effective. That's going to be a video in itself. So, 14,569 gold. That's actually a little better than I thought it would be. And that's interesting. Now, there's the value of things to break down. The cauliflower pumpkins are worth the most, which I figured they would be. The only surprise is the value of that. That's not bad. I know that was money I definitely needed. So what do we do now? We could sit here and let this snow slowly accumulate on top of my red cowboy hat. You know what we're going to do? We're going to see how long it takes us to get a giant crop in the greenhouse. We're going to plant some mixed seeds. I did see lots of pumpkins in there. And we're also going to destroy those. But there were enough pumpkins that I think if I was to harvest these every single day, I might be able to get a giant one by the end of winter. And that's what we're going to do to find out. And I'm really excited about this idea now, but I feel like it's going to be one of those ideas that turns into one that I hate by the end, because I didn't think this through at all. But we have coffee to thank for that. Now, the trick is going to be harvesting and growing these every day, because I'm going to have to make them grow. I'm not going to water them and do it naturally. Ooh, so far we're not getting a lot of pumpkins. This is some bad luck now. Okay, well, there's a little cluster up top. It's helpful when they're closer together like that, so that's actually good. We got a nice cluster in the upper right, none anywhere else. So now I've got to very carefully harvest all these around them pumpkins, which won't be too bad. I've just got to do this once a day, and hopefully by the end of the month we get pumpkins, because if not, we're not going to get another chance, because cauliflower is going to start to grow instead. The most annoying part of this is going to be clearing out the crops around the pumpkins, because it's so time-consuming to do, and I got to be so picky about it. Whoops. Anyways, there we go. Just like that. The pumpkins are all cleared out. I gotta remove these somehow. Was tempted to use bombs. Still might. Still a little nervous about that. But because I'm lazy, we're gonna try it anyway. We're gonna work our way inwards. Ooh, that actually was a lot closer than I thought it was gonna be. All right, let's put one there. I'll probably only get away with this for the first day anyway, because after that, there's gonna be pumpkins out here, and I don't want to risk losing any pumpkins after today. All right, one more controlled demolition. Really hope that doesn't hit my pumpkins. All right, we're good. I am also actually going to reseed all this today, simply because I don't want to lose the whole dirt overnight. Not that it's a big deal with my tractor, because all I gotta do is go like this to do the whole thing. But there we go. I'm hoping the orange ones are pumpkin seeds, but I don't actually know. That'd be really cool if it was. So those are gonna stay right where they are. I want to do this once per day. I honestly don't really know why I've given this idea imaginary parameters like that, but I have. So we'll just go with it. For a second, as I entered the greenhouse, I was in shock because none of my crops had grown, and then I remembered I have to do that manually. Oh, those aren't pumpkins. Okay, well, we got another one up in that corner. They like that corner for some reason. I didn't really pay attention to what seeds spawn the pumpkins. Okay, we did get one in the lower left too, so this thing's getting a lot more annoying to do. And for them to turn giant, we are going to have to start watering them, but luckily I can do that at a touch of a button too. I wish there was a way to harvest everything but pumpkins all at once, but I'm not going to have that luxury. Harvested for a second time, that's what our pumpkin patch currently looks like, and it's nice gathering up in the corner, but it might still honestly be years before I get the pumpkins to fill that void. But only one way to find out, jump on the tractor. There we go, hopefully some of those are pumpkins, and I'll see you tomorrow. Alright, here we go again, give me some pumpkins. Ooh, we're actually getting lots of pumpkins, I like where this is going. Curious that they like that right side so much more. That's probably purely chance. I don't see any reason why it wouldn't be, but it's coming along pretty nicely. Pumpkins are filling up, and we still got 24 days to do this, which is good and bad because that gives us lots of time, but also lots of time that it might take. There it is as it currently stands. Let's do it for another day. Oh, and hopefully the pumpkins didn't change too much. I did accidentally pick two of them along the way because tool hit location lies to me a lot. I simply replanted the pumpkin and made it grow right away, and I'm pretty sure I got them in the same spot, but if they did change a little bit, that's why. There we go, and see you tomorrow. And we're back with day whatever of this stupid experiment. As you can see, the pumpkins are filling out pretty nicely. I think within a few days, we should be able to start getting some giant ones. And as soon as I get a giant one, this case is closed. And that's what it looks like, all cleaned up. Does anyone want to take any guesses on how long it's going to take to get an even 9 square of pumpkins? Next day result, a few more pumpkins, not a lot, but we're getting there. Pumpkins are starting to dominate. If we're really lucky, we could actually get our 9 square of pumpkins tomorrow. And then within a few days, they should be giant. So let's hope we actually get lucky for once. Knowing me, I absolutely won't, and it will sit just like that until the end of time. I forgot to lay down my new seeds. It's getting so very close now, especially that upper right. I honestly think after a few days, I am going to start to get some giant ones up and right, or at least the potential to get some giant ones. Because, as we know, just because they form in a neat square of 9, they're not going to turn giant right away. They've got to continuously be watered if you want that to happen. It always looks so much better once it's cleaned up. I mean, look at it now. You really see how many pumpkins there are. And we're getting 3 or 4 new ones a day, so after tomorrow, add another 3 or 4. You can see by the end of the month, this is actually going to fill up pretty nicely, provided it stays at 3 or 4 pumpkins a day. But at the same time, we know that it's not, because these are obviously taking up some of the space required to get 3 or 4 pumpkins. Whoops. Okay, so... Might have to go back to recording to replant those pumpkins. Note to self, don't jump on the tractor with your scythe out. I was thinking it was going to be safe to do that, because I don't have Harvest with Scythe on, but your tractor automatically turns that on. So I'm going to try and replant that as best I can. Well, I think I got it back to where I needed to be. Doing that actually made me realize how much real estate there still is in this greenhouse to fill with pumpkins, but I'm going to be really careful now how I interact with that tractor. Like, really careful. But that is back to where it is. I checked the recording. That was a lot of fun. Alright, I feel we did pretty good with the pumpkins, particularly on that right side. I definitely saw a few more over here. They continue to kind of avoid the left side, and I'm okay with that. As long as I stay on the right side, I'll get some giant ones before too much longer. So there it is, cleaned up after this fine day. Let's do it all again. Pretty bad luck day today with the pumpkins. Didn't get a lot on the right side. I got 2 over here, and that might have actually been it. It's kind of hard to tell day to day, but it wasn't very many. Cleaned up. Like I said, not very many new ones today. Life goes on. Today, I'm not honestly sure I saw any new pumpkins. There might have been one on the left, but that was some really bad luck. I gotta start finding some of these pretty quick. There's its cleaned up form. I'm actually getting pretty efficient at that. Again, I'm not sure there was any new pumpkins at all. There was probably 1 or 2, but none really that caught my attention. None there was any good locations. I guess any pumpkins is helpful at this point because I just need to fill the whole damn greenhouse. It's the 11th of winter today. I started this basically on the 2nd because I wasted the first day. There it is cleaned up. I do feel like there's some new pumpkins there, but I'm just kind of zoning out because this idea is starting to bore me quite a bit. New seeds laid down. Whoops. Get on the tractor. Get on. There it is. Okay. And that's my process. I did see a few new pumpkins today. One was in the middle somewhere and one was over on the left. None of which really helps me. This is probably the closest spot right here. Another 2 would get that one done. Actually right here again, 2 pumpkins would get that one done. Cleaned up. It's starting to feel pretty full of pumpkins, but none of which have the potential to turn giant just yet. And another day down. And that's what it looks like after another day. But this does go to show you that this idea is plausible. It would take 13 days for the pumpkins to grow, at which point you'd be exchanging the seeds until you got pumpkin seeds. They would all grow. Then you'd have until the last day of the month to get them into a group of 9. Although, you would need better luck than I have to make this work. We're 1 away right here. If we get 1 there, we can start watering these. But I'm going to keep going until we get at least 1 mega, because I want to see this one through. After today, there's definitely a few areas where we're so very close to getting a square of 9. We get a few pumpkins anywhere in here. It's funny because initially this was getting very filled out, but then it went heavy on the left side for pumpkins, so hopefully that trend continues. More pumpkins anywhere really at this point is going to pretty much get us there. Well, after today, one thing is clear. We got a nice clean edge of pumpkins along the northern edge, so that's fun, but completely not helpful. Do you see what I see? The 18th of winter, and we finally have the chance to get a mega pumpkin right here. It's funny because the left side was so sparse for so long, then suddenly we got lucky with it. There, just like that, all cleaned up, we finally have our spot, and there's actually a little bit of extra room, so we have extra potential to get that mega crop. But it's not there yet, so we're going to water everything today, replant, and hope for the best. Today's the big day. We're going to find out if we got lucky or not. Not yet. But things are starting to grow because they were watered. That confused me for a sec. We're going to make them grow, see if we got any more pumpkins along the way. Probably not, knowing my luck. I think we might have got one somewhere here, but none that are really going to matter. And there it is, once again, all cleaned up, because I just like the way that looks. Still no mega pumpkins, despite the potential. I did see 2 new pumpkins sprout up, some are bottom right, some are upper mid, so it's getting very full. So every day we're getting a little bit closer to our goal, but we're still not there yet. So yay, more time. Once again watered, once again, nothing mega. Today's the day I'm feeling lucky. I believe this is our 3rd day with the potential for the mega crop. Might even be 4th, and we didn't get it. Well, there's always tomorrow. We're so close, but it's so hard to get any pumpkins to spawn at this point. We're getting maybe 1 per day. If we had a lucky day and got, say, 3 or 4 to spawn in there, that would be great. I notice a lot of corn, and I notice a lot of the grass stuff growing. Every day is like Christmas, with disappointing results. All I need to do is have that spot go mega. So close. There are only 5 days left in winter, so I need a giant one to show up pretty soon, or I'm going to miss my opportunity. I could keep watering into spring, but I kind of want to limit this to 1 month time. While I got lucky today with a few extra pumpkins at least, I now have the potential to get a mega one down here, but I still didn't get a mega one in the usual spot, but at least our odds are a little bit increased now. Well, it's the 28th today and we still don't have any giant crops. What we do have are a lot of small pumpkins though, and we got one new one today, but as far as I can tell, there's only a few spots where a mega one could even form. Actually, we got lots of area up here now thanks to this morning's pumpkin. We got some areas here, we got some areas here. They still didn't want to go mega. I did start this on the 2nd of winter, so we would technically have one more day to do this, but the parameters I made up were pretty much just imaginary anyway. I just wanted to see if it would happen before the end of the month, and it didn't. So I'm going to try this for one more day because we still get mixed seeds for winter for one more day. After tomorrow, we have no chance of pumpkins, so one more day to make this work. I feel like a failure now that the snow's gone and I don't have any mega pumpkins. Unless I happen to have one today. Nope. Typical disappointing result. Not surprised. Did we get any more pumpkins at least? They stand out now when I get them. Yeah, we got a few right there actually, so we got a huge potential for mega pumpkins here. Well, I think what I'm going to do at this point is destroy all the non-pumpkins and then just blast through time until we actually get a mega one to form. I'm going to wake up, water, skip the day, wake up, water, skip the day, for maybe a week at a time until we finally get a mega pumpkin to form and see how long that takes. It's the idea that just never ends because I made up stupid imaginary parameters for it. Anyways, this is the result. Like I said, I started it on the 2nd of winter, so I would have had one more day. I might have got two more pumpkins at best out of that, but it all depends on luck largely. It's been 1 week of water greenhouse. The grass is growing wild and that's just not a problem. Do I have any giant pumpkins? I do not. Wow, this is gonna take forever. I don't know why it's not working. So I came up with this great idea that I could just use iridium sprinklers to water from now on instead of manually doing it with the water all crops button would make this marginally faster. But the problem I have is this pumpkin right here. It can't be watered by any sprinkler currently and I'm wondering what to do about that. I really don't want to destroy any pumpkins to get a sprinkler a little bit closer to it because I need this square so bad because this square is definitely the best chance of getting a mega pumpkin. So I guess I'm just going to continue on like I have been, water all fields, skipping the day, I'll see you in another week. One amazingly fun week later. Do we have any mega crops yet? That was 7 full days of watering pumpkins. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Okay, well, I'm going to give it to the end of spring, and if we don't get a mega one then, I'm giving up because maybe mega ones just don't want to happen anymore. Fine. The end of spring? Nothing. Great. But I guess that's really not that surprising, being that even when you plant a big crop outside in your field, you have all this space to do it, and even if you cover most of it, it's still pretty hard to get a mega crop, and I mean, look how much bigger the field is compared to the greenhouse. Now, if I kept watering, I would eventually get the mega crops in there. I just don't know exactly how long it would take. It might take years, and I just don't have that kind of time anymore, because this idea already took quite a lot of time. So on that note, I gotta go edit this mess. So I hope you liked it. Thank you all for watching.